Welcome to UGC E Pachala, PG Learning and Food Science. I'm Mrs. Shajini Judith, Assistant Professor from the Department of Home Science, Women's Christian College, and I'm going to be discussing meat cookery with you today. In this module, I will be teaching you the different dry heat and moist heat methods of cooking meat, the methods of heat transfer while cooking meat, and also help you to identify suitable cooking methods for different cuts of meat and prepare different meat dishes. Meat is a relatively expensive commodity. It is often the focal point of a meal and should be well cooked. Meat dishes are always a delicacy at home. Correctly cooked meat should be succulent and tender. Poor cooking can spoil the good quality meat and make it dry, tough, and stringy. So the main aim in cooking meat is to make them look and taste more appetizing, tender and more digestible, safer to eat by destroying the harmful bacteria in them. Now meat, the beef and the lamb, they can be cooked by two methods, the dry heat methods and the moist heat methods. The dry heat methods are those methods which do not use liquid, but only use air or oil as a medium of cooking. The dry heat methods of cooking are more suitable for the tender cuts of meat or the medium tender cuts. Less tender cuts of meat cannot be cooked by dry heat and can be made tender only by the moist heat methods of cooking. So I told you about how in the dry heat methods, air or oil is used as a medium of cooking. But then in the moist heat methods, the meat is cooked with the help of water or steam, and less tender cuts are usually cooked by the moist heat methods. Now when I say cooking cannot be done without heat. There are three basic mechanisms by which heat is transferred during the cooking of meat: conduction, convection, and radiation. These are three components which most of us have already studied it in our lower classes in the subject called physics. Now, what is conduction? In conduction, the kinetic energy is transmitted from one molecule to another without displacement of the molecules. The muscle tissues are heated primarily by conduction when there is a direct contact with a heat source, such as the heated surfaces of electric range burners or the flame of gas burners. This diagram will help us to understand the method of heat transfer by conduction. In conduction, the heat travels through a solid surface. When you place the pan or the vessel on the heated surface, like a burner or a cooking range or a stove, the heat from the heat source is conducted to the solid surface of the pan or the vessel, and it helps in heating up the contents of the pan. So the molecules that are in close contact with the heat at the bottom of the pan, they become less dense and rise, and the molecules that are there on the top, which are colder, they get displaced and come to the bottom. So in this manner, a kind of a convection current is set up, whereby the less denser part molecules move up and the cold denser molecules move down. So in conduction, heat is transmitted from the hot surface onto the pan by conduction, and then the contents of the pan or the vessel get scooped by the convection currents that are set up. The second method of heat transfer is called as the convection. In convection cooking, the heated air moves in currents around the piece of meat and the surrounding medium. So here the air moves around the meat, the heated air, and helps in cooking the meat. The convection currents may occur naturally because of simple changes that occur when a gas or liquid is heated, thus becoming less dense and rising. Convection currents are mechanically stimulated by a blower in a convection oven, making cooking more economical because it results in time and power savings. When convection currents are set up, heat is transmitted rapidly, and this helps in reducing the time taken for cooking. Since convection ovens transmit heat rapidly, they cook 20% to 40% faster than conventional ovens. So when you're cooking meat in a convection oven, be careful to adjust the time and the temperature to avoid overcooking the meat, because when meat is overcooked, it can become dry and affect its cooking quality. When meat is cooked in a conventional oven, electromagnetic waves of radiant energy pass from the heat source to the pan in which the meat rests and then into the meat. So this is how convection currents are set up. When heated air or liquid is moving, the convection currents are set up. So the hot air or the liquid, they rise, and the cold air or the liquid, they fall down to take its place. Eventually, the entire area gets heated up. The third method of heat transfer is radiation. Two types of radiations are used in meat cookery: the infrared and the microwaves. Infrared radiation is the transfer of heat energy by long electromagnetic waves which pass from a high temperature surface to a low temperature surface. The form of heat transfer is particularly important at high temperatures. Radiant energy may come from boiler units in conventional ovens or from glowing coals. So this method of heat transfer occurs through air media and is slowed down within a solid piece of meat. Microwave cooking has become very popular these days. In microwave radiation, the microwaves that are generated by the magnetron in the microwave, they help in cooking the meat which is placed inside the microwave oven. Now the characteristic of the microwaves are, these waves can penetrate the food and excite the water molecules within them. So when the microwaves excite the water molecules within the meat or the food, the water molecules begin to move rapidly and they also vibrate at a great speed. Now because of this vibration, which occurs at a high speed, the molecules rub against one another. And so as a result of this molecules rubbing against one another, a great amount of friction is produced, as a result of which heat is produced, and this helps in cooking the meat. When heat is radiated, it travels in straight lines and any object in its path becomes heated. So this happens when you cook meat in a griller or in a toaster or in a microwave. The microwaves help in cooking the meat by denaturing the protein within the meat, but the microwaves are capable of penetrating into the meat only to a depth of about half an inch. When cooked in a microwave oven, the inner portion of the thick cuts of meat is heated primarily through conduction. Since bones reflect the microwaves, the meat nearest to the bone does not heat well. So the meat that is found surrounding the bones are not heated well, or not, they are not cooked well in other terms. Now surface evaporative cooling is also observed in microwave when meat is cooked by roasting. This may explain some of the uneven cooking that has been reported in meat prepared in a microwave oven. Okay, so the cause for uneven cooking in microwave oven is because the microwaves have the capacity to penetrate into the meat for a depth of only about half an inch. And moreover, since the bones reflect the heat, the portions of meat around the bones do not get cooked. Because surface temperature is low and moisture is deposited on the surface of the meat, a cooked crust may not form on the meat when meat is cooked by microwave cooking. Browning meat in a microwave oven depends upon a time and temperature relationship. For example, browning normally does not occur in small pieces of meat because they have a short cooking time. Okay, so now we've looked into the three methods of heat transfer that help in cooking meat: the conduction, the convection, and the radiation. Let's now move on to the different dry heat methods of cooking meat. Dry heat methods are those methods which use either oil or air as a medium of cooking. There is absolutely no water or steam involved in dry heat methods. The different dry heat methods are roasting, grilling, shallow frying, and deep frying. The moist heat methods are those which use a liquid in the form of water or steam, and they are most suitable for cooking the less tender cuts of meat which have more connective tissue in them. The moist heat methods are braising, which also includes casseroling and pot roasting and stewing, poaching, simmering, steaming, and pressure cooking. Now, the method of cooking that we choose while cooking meat is solely dependent on the amount of connective tissue present in meat. Meat cuts that have a lot of connective tissue in them are very tough, and they need moist heat and longer time of cooking and slower cooking time to make them tender. But not all connective tissue will become tender by the moist heat methods. Now, the connective tissue have two important components in them: the low elastic connective tissue, which is referred to as the elastin, and the white connective tissue, which is referred to as the collagen. Collagen usually becomes soft and tender and gelatinized by the slow moist heat cooking methods, but elastin is a very tough tissue and it will not become tender under the ordinary temperatures of cooking. Heat will make it shrink and harden. So it is important that we remove the tough elastin tissue before cooking in order to help reduce the level of toughness in some cuts of meat. Okay, now let me tell you the cuts of meat that have a large amount of collagen and elastin in them. The shank, the shin, and the shoulder cuts of beef and lamb, they contain more collagen and elastin. So while choosing the cuts of meat that have more of connective tissue in them, they need to be cooked slowly by moist heat methods in order to gelatinize the collagen. Now, cuts with less collagen are meat cuts such as fillet and sirloin, and they contain very little connective tissue. So, in order to make them tender, the dry heat cooking methods are better. They are more suitable, like the grilling or searing, and short time, high temperature roasting. Now, we'll look into each one of these dry heat methods in detail. First, we will talk about roasting. Roasting is cooking meat uncovered in hot air in an oven. They can also be placed on a spit over a fire. The meat is usually placed uncovered in a rack in a shallow pan to keep the meat out of drippings. The roasting pan is placed in the center of the oven at a temperature of 163 to 177 degrees Celsius. Now, this temperature will ensure the adequate browning of the meat, and a good flavor and a good appearance can be obtained by roasting meat. Now, meat can also be cooked by pot roasting. Now, this is the term. Now, this method of pot roasting is used for larger cuts or joints of meat, and there's hardly any liquid that is used in this type of cooking. This is a good method for cooking the less tender cuts of meat, such as the fresh beef silver side, the top side, and the chuck roast. Grilling is also referred to as boiling. Meat can also be cooked by grilling. This is a quick cooking method because the meat comes into direct contact with the heat surface. Now, the heat is usually generated from a gas flame or from a heated electric element. Now, meat is placed under or over the heat surface, and it's usually the tender cuts of meat which are usually grilled. When meats are cooked by grilling, care should be taken to turn the meat over at frequent intervals for uniform cooking. Now, broiling is also a dry heat method of cooking meat. To broil, meat is placed on a rack, and the rack is adjusted in such a way that the top of the meat is about 5 to 2 centimeters away from the source of heat. A tray should be placed beneath the meat rack, which will help us to collect the melted fat or the drippings. And broiling is usually carried out at a temperature of 176 degrees Celsius until the top side is brown. When the top side is brown, the broiled side is salted, and then it is turned over and broiled on the other side. This ensures uniform cooking and browning. Broiling is a faster method of cooking than roasting, but it is by roasting that we are able to produce more juicy and tender meats than the broiled meats. Barbecuing is another dry heat method of cooking meat, which is slowly gaining a lot of popularity in most of the Indian restaurants. Here, meat is cooked on a grid or spit over glowing coals or gas flames. Before the meat is barbecued, it is adequately marinated in spices to make it flavorful and also to tenderize the meat. Okay, now let's move on to fan grilling, which again is a dry heat method of cooking meat. This is by cooking meat in a multifunctional oven using radiant heat energy from the upper element, and the heated air is circulated by a fan, which helps in setting up convection currents. There is a thermostat here which controls the temperature, and the oven door is kept closed. Fan grilling is suitable for cooking the tender cuts of meats and for some roasts. Pan grilling is again a dry heat method of cooking meat, where the meat is cooked on a preheated heavy dry frying pan or ridged iron griddle or a metal hot plate. Now, this is not frying because we are not going to be using any oil on the surface of the pan, but sometimes the cooking surface can be lightly greased or the meat can be brushed with a little oil before cooking. But no further fat is added during the cooking process, and any fat drippings that accumulates is usually collected and taken off. The meat is cooked uncovered. Moving on to the pan frying or the shallow frying method. Here, the meat is cooked in a very small quantity of oil or fat, usually about 3 to 12 millimeters in depth, in an uncovered pan. This is a very suitable method or an appropriate method for cooking the thin cuts of tender meat. Stir frying is also something similar to the shallow frying, but here the finely cut meat is rapidly stirred and tossed into a hot pan, which is greased with a little oil, or it can also be cooked over in a wok over a high heat. Sauteing is also a dry heat method of cooking meat. Saute literally means to jump. In other words, small pieces of meat are tossed in the pan using a spatula or a similar utensil as they cook in a little hot oil or fat. Now, the pan that is used for sauteing is slightly deeper than the one that is used for shallow frying. This method, the method of sauteing, is an appropriate method for cooking thin slices of small pieces of tender meat. Sometimes a saute may be finished with a sauce cooked in the pan. Deep fat frying is cooking meat by completely immersing it in hot oil or fat. Now, when the meat is cooked by deep fat frying, there are many things that need to be taken into account. The temperature has to be controlled in deep fat frying because sometimes the meat does not develop a burnt flavor and it becomes dry. At very high temperatures, the fat decomposes to form acrolein, which can spoil the flavor of the meat. And now this acrolein, when fat decomposes to acrolein, it can also irritate the mucus layers of the nose and cause sneezing. And too high temperature results in when the temperature used in the deep fat frying is very high, sometimes the outer portions get cooked while the inner portions remain uncooked. And if the meat is fried at a very low temperature, it results in a greasier product. So moving on to the moist heat methods. Moist heat methods of cooking are suitable for less tender cuts of meat, and it is also a slow method of cooking when compared to most of the dry heat methods. Moist heat cooking helps to reduce surface drying, whereas surface drying is very common in the dry heat methods of cooking. Unless a pressure cooker is used, cooking temperatures are generally low in the case of moist heat methods. Only in a pressure cooker, the temperature that is reached is very high. And while in the other methods of moist heat cooking, the temperature is generally low and it's usually maintained at the boiling temperature. Now, in the case of the moist heat methods, the heat penetration is very fast and rapid on comparing with the dry heat methods, because the steam and the water in the case of the moist heat methods, they help to conduct heat very rapidly. With moist heat methods, the meat sometimes may lose water, and along with the water, some water soluble nutrients are also lost into the cooking liquid. So it is recommended that in the case of moist heat methods, the cooking liquid should not be thrown away, but they can be consumed in the form of a stew or a soup, such that the nutrients are retained and that they are not lost. Now, moist heat methods, as I told you, involves cooking the meat in a liquid. The less tender cuts of meat can be covered with a liquid and gently simmered until the meat becomes tender. Care should be taken not to let the temperature of the liquid exceed the boiling point, because this will toughen the proteins of the meat and make it unpalatable. When the liquid is used as a base for a soup, that is when the liquid in which the meat is cooked is used as a base for a soup, it is called as a stock. It's also called as a broth or a bouillon. Meat that is partially cooked in liquid before cooking by another method is called as parboiled meat. Now, these are the different moist heat methods of cooking meat. They are the stewing, steaming, pressure cooking, poaching, boiling, simmering and blanching. Now, stewing or casseroling is a moist heat method of cooking meat, wherein the meat is cut into small pieces or cubes and it is cooked at a low temperature, or it is allowed to gently simmer in the liquid along with vegetables in a covered pan on the top of the stove or in the oven. And before the meat is stewed subjected to stewing, it is usually seared or browned, because this helps in imparting a unique flavor to the meat. In the case of stewing, care should be taken to see that the steam that comes out from the cooking water does not escape. So a tight fitting pan, the pan should be fitted with a tight fitting lid. So in the case of simmering, the meat is gently cooked in water or in a liquid. Here the water is maintained, the temperature of the cooking water is maintained below the boiling point. So the bubbles, you will not find them boiling vigorously, but they barely ripple. Now, meats that are simmered are usually the small cuts of meat, and sometimes large pieces of meat like the corned beef silver side are also cooked by simmering. Now, poaching. Now, poaching is a traditional way by which usually the poultry or the fish is cooked. Egg is also poached. However, meat is not poached quite frequently, but then beef roast can be successfully poached if the beef is obtained from the tender cut. Now, in the case of poaching, food is cooked very gently in a liquid that is below the simmering point. The liquid is hot, but it should not exceed a mere tremble. And there is less movement, in the case of simmering. It's not boiling vigorously. So the meat is initially browned or seared, and then the poaching liquid is added to it, and then the meat is roasted, and the meat is simmered until it becomes tender, and it is usually cooked at a temperature of 130 degrees Fahrenheit, which I told you is below the boiling point. Now the liquid in which the meat is poached, it could be a beef broth or a red wine or a mixture of herbs. Now this liquid can be used to make a simple sauce after the meat has been poached, or it can be strained and frozen and used for and used later as a soup base or as a stewing liquid. Braising is also a moisted method of cooking meat, and this usually combines two or three different methods of moisted methods of cooking. Meat is also cooked by braising. This is a method where you will find a combination of cooking methods. Meat is first browned in a minimum of fat or oil, and then it is cooked gently along with vegetables and a small amount of liquid in a tightly covered pot or a casserole on the stove top or in the oven. Usually, the serving sized pieces of meat as well as larger cuts of meat can be cooked by braising. Pressure cooking is also one way of cooking meat. Now, the principle under which the pressure cooker works is the steam that is generated when the water boils is not allowed to escape, as a result of which the heat that is generated inside a pressure cooker is very high because the steam is not allowed to escape and it is held under pressure. So the temperatures reached in a pressure cooker is very high, and it reduces the cooking time taken to cook the meat. I mean, it reduces the time taken for cooking the meat. Usually, it's only about 1/3 of the normal cooking time that is taken to cook meat in comparison to other methods of cooking. Now, in the pressure cooker, the less tender cuts of meat can be cooked to make it tender, and then the offals of the animals, like the ox tongue and the beef and the shin part of the muscle, also can be made tender by cooking in a pressure cooker. Microwave cookery, this also combines the moist heat and the dry heat methods. I've already spoken to you about the principles of microwave cooking. So I told you about how the magnetron in the microwave oven, it produces electromagnetic waves which strike the meat, and they excite the water molecules in the meat, and as a result of which the water molecules vibrate rapidly and produces friction, and the friction produces heat, and this heat helps in cooking the meat. But the microwave oven can also be used to roast, simmer, braise and casserole meats. However, it gives very different results in terms of taste and flavor when compared to the other conventional cooking methods. And cooking meat in a microwaver is generally not a time saver, and the power settings and the other adjustments need to be carried on to get the desired browning and to allow uniform cooking in the microwave oven. So with this, we have come to the end of this module. We have looked at the different dry heat and the moist heat methods of cooking. And as we all know, the early man, he accidentally discovered that cooked meats taste much better than raw meat. Since then, it is known that cooking improves the taste, texture and flavor of meat and makes it more palatable. So from this module, we have understood the importance of cooking meat and the method of cooking that is suitable for the tender and the less tender cuts of meat. Thank you.